with precious few days before an election, a lot of time gets spent on endorsements for candidates. In between the debates, in between raising money, what other ways do you try and create momentum for your candidacy? Well, you roll out prominent people or influential groups supporting that candidate. And in my experience, particularly in presidential election years, most of those endorsements aren't worth the paper they're printed on. It's not that those groups aren't significant and that they also don't work very hard for the candidate. And some groups certainly are more politically active and energized than others and have had some impact in past elections. But keep in mind, this is a presidential election year where the Romney-Obama race is sucking all the oxygen out of the air and dominating the airwaves as well as the space in newspapers and on the radio. So it's very difficult for these races further down on the ballot to get any attention at all. So these endorsements for state senate candidates or for state house candidates or even candidates for the executive council from groups on the right like the Republican Liberty Alliance to groups on the left like the Sierra Club really are not going to move the needle very much at the end of the day. The only thing, marginal thing they could do is what mechanically they can do on the ground in the way of volunteer support, making phone calls, helping canvas, helping candidates go door to door in a close election that this could be, that could certainly help on the margins. And certainly we're seeing Planned Parenthood or Northern New England make an unprecedented effort to try and help that marginal release with spending $500,000 on essentially a ground game campaign to try and help elect Democratic candidate for Governor Maggie Hassan, several Democratic candidates for the Executive Council, and other targeted races for the legislature. That's the kind of effort that could, as I say, add a point or two to a candidate's campaign. On the main, whether it's outgoing Governor John Lynch, who's very popular, to the six Republican governors who've supported Republican candidate Ovid Lamontagne, I don't think that's going to close the sale for either Democratic candidate Maggie Hassan or Republican Ovid Lamontagne.